The factory wasted no time going for that signature look with a laced front rim and a front fender that was pared down to the bare minimum with blackout fork sliders in between. A blackout triple tree mounts a similarly dark, single headlight can ahead of a pair of blackout clocks that contain all the instrumentation. The painters were relentless with the blackout treatment, and it goes on to encompass the handlebar, mirrors, frame, engine jugs as well as the cases, rear shock and swinger. In back we have another set of standoff, LED turn signals and a bolt-up tail light with all black housings and hardware. Much like the front fender, the rear fender is clean, simple and just big enough to do the job with a flashy, pinstripe graphic for a bit of bling, you know, just to offset the complete dearth of chrome. The pinstripe graphic joins the Snake Eyes badge on the long, narrow fuel tank for a nice bit of continuity of design. A solo seat rides on the shortest stub of a subframe, and believe me when I say that this isn't a two if they are good enough friends kind of solo seat. I mean this is a one-butt saddle. I would be remiss if I didn't point out that the butt in question will be more comfortable if it comes with its own padding, because there isn't much in the way of cushion in the Snake Eyes saddle. Just saying.